Rand Paul is at a meeting, and Clive Bundy shows up. So they say, hey, Clive is here. Of course, this guy is the most anti-government extremist ever. Really should have been shot and killed the last time he had a standoff with the government when his posse out there was aiming guns at federal agents. Somebody should have taken him out then. But the truth is, he's still kind of that talking guy for the fringe right, even though what was it that he said? That African Americans were much happier in slavery. Okay, so now all of a sudden the media says, even Fox News, maybe they backed down a little bit from Cliven, but Rand Paul doesn't. Rand Paul doubles down with Clive Bundy. Tell us his story.
What is it? You know, what you just pointed out is the fact that even after he said that, you know, black people were happier slaves, Sean Hannity had the good sense to say, okay, look, we're not going to support you anymore. We can't. You've crossed the line. And then Rand Paul is giving this speech out in Nevada. His people recognize Cliven Bundy in the audience, go up to him and say, hey, you want a private audience with Rand Paul? Come on back here. You know, Cliven says, oh, I thought I was going to go shake his hand. They sat down for 45 minutes discussing policy. Cliven Bundy says that he helped to educate Rand Paul about how they handle land issues within the states in the Southwest, which, you know, Cliven Bundy has been the poster child for the right-wing militia since 2 years ago when he did recruited all these people with the help of Alex Jones and Glenn Beck, who got their base all frenzied up to go out there and point rifles at federal agents.